新嘅補償安置嘅安排。咁第一咧就我哋係聽到政府嘅建議之後咧，政府係好明顯聽咗我哋好多村民同埋地區朋友嘅意見，係放寬咗安置同埋補償嘅安排。我哋希望佢進一步聆聽。第一，我哋要求佢哋喺收地嘅安排上邊咧，盡量係以一次過嘅收地嘅方式去進行，而唔係分階段。因為分階段進行收地咧，喺工地附近嘅村民日常生活嘅環境會受好大嘅影響。我哋希望政府可以一次過安置佢哋。第二，現在政府話可以俾佢哋喺百和路嘅公營房屋嗰度安置，不過百和路公營房屋嘅單位咧，要去到2023年先至落成，期間可以喺房協同埋房委會嘅空置單位暫住。但係大家知道咧，其實房協喺北區基本上係冇單位嘅，所以村民咧係好可能要搬嚟北區。如果要喺北區嘅公屋居住咧，北區嘅公屋供應其實我嘅理解咧都係好緊張嘅，所以我哋要求政府係盡量做到原區安置，讓我哋受影響嘅村民可以繼續喺北區生活。因為好多時候啲村民佢嘅家庭嘅聯繫，佢哋仔女讀書都喺翻北區，如果佢哋要搬嚟北區咧，會對佢哋嘅生活有好大嘅影響。第三，其實喺之前凍結登記嘅時候咧，有好多村民係凍結登記嘅時候已經登記咗嘅，不過好遺憾之後咧，佢哋係受到有啲地主業主嘅逼遷，導致佢哋要搬嚟住咗數以十年嘅居所。所以如果政府係嚟緊再次做登記嘅時間，如果按現在的政策，佢哋唔喺原址居住嘅話，可能會喪失佢哋安置同埋補償嘅資格。我要求政府將現在放寬咗嘅計劃涵蓋埋呢一批喺首次凍結登記嘅時候已經登記咗嘅村民，雖然佢哋俾業主逼遷離開佢哋嘅家園，我認為只要佢哋證明到佢哋喺上址居住嘅年份同埋其他嘅資格係符合政府嘅要求嘅話，政府係應該安置埋呢一批被逼遷離開嘅村民。咁另一方面，我近年都一直批評政府60萬嘅特惠補償係完全脫節嘅。今次政府咧提高到上限係120萬，咁我認為呢個亦都係聆聽咗我哋嘅聲音。雖然係遲噶啦，因為大家知道個樓價其實升咗好多噶啦，近呢6、7年嘅時間，但係遲總好過冇。佢而家提高翻個安置補償咧，呢個係好重要嘅。我希望政府咧係全面檢視有關嘅安置補償嘅政策，唔單止喺東北發展嘅項目，其他政府嘅發展項目都係應該要用一個寬鬆嘅標準，讓村民受影響嘅居民獲得一個合理嘅補償同埋安置咯。OK。Yes。I think the government have already listened to some of our opinions to rehouse the villages affected by the development project. And I urge the government to rehouse all the villages, one-off rehouse them. And I also urge the government to prepare sufficient public housing public housing flats for the rehousing, and because so many of the villagers live in North District for decades, and their network and most of their children study in North District, so I urge the government to prepare sufficient public housing for the rehousing arrangement. And I also urge the government to let those registered villagers who were forced to leave their home because of the landlord decision. So I urge the government to let those related villagers to be covered by the new policy of the government. Okay, thank you. Okay.